Information. Water has been detected in interstellar clouds within our galaxy, the Milky Way. Water probably exists in a market in other galaxies, too, because its components, hydrogen and oxygen, are among the most abundant elements in the universe. Interstellar clouds eventually condense into solar nebulae and solar systems such as ours. A view of the Carina Nebula shows star Earth in a new level of detail. The fantasy-like landscape of the nebula is sculpted by the action of a flowing wind and scorching ultraviolet radiation from the monster stars that inhabit this inferno. In the process, these stars are shredding the surrounding material that is the last vestige of the giant cloud from which the stars were born. The immense nebula is an estimated 7,500 light years away in the southern constellation Carina, the king of the old southern constellation Argonavis, the ship of Jason and the Argonauts from Greek mythology. This image is a mosaic of the Carina Nebula assembled from 48 frames taken with Hubble Space Telescope's advanced camera for survey. The Hubble images were taken in the light of ionized hydrogen. Color information was added with data taken at the 7th Tomorrow Inter-American Observatory in Chile. Red corresponds to sulfur, green to hydrogen, and blue to oxygen emission. In astronomy, the habitable zone, HZ, is the distance from a star where an Earth-like planet can maintain liquid water on its surface and Earth-like life. The habitable zone is the intersection of two regions that must both be favorable to life. One within a planetary system, and the other within a galaxy. Planets and moons in these regions are the likeliest candidates to be habitable and thus capable of bearing extraterrestrial life similar to our own. The concept generally does not include moons, because there is insufficient evidence and theory to speculate what moons might be habitable on account of their proximity to the planet. The habitable zone is not to be confused with the planetary habitability. While planetary habitability deals solely with the planetary conditions required to maintain carbon-based life, the habitable zone deals with the stellar conditions required to maintain carbon-based life, and these two factors are not left to be interchanged. Life is most likely to form within the circumstellar habitable zone, CHZ, within a solar system, and the galactic habitable zone, GHZ, of the larger galaxy, though research on the latter point remains in its infancy. GHZ may also be referred to as the Black Zone, Comfort Zone, Green Belt, or Goldilocks Zone, because it's neither too hot nor too cold, but just right.
Since it will fit within the notion of symmetry, if it is not absolute, is it unattractive? One idea is to replace instantaneous communication with a process which travels backwards in time along the fast light curve. Is it the idea behind the transactional interpretation of quantum mechanics, which interprets the statistical emergence of a quantum history as a gradual coming to a frequent distinct history that go forward or have happened in time?
I'm Thank you. Thank you.
information. Let's start our call. They're both in the company plans to walk out the cooling podcast and does. When this has blown off the deal with the venture, the impacts the surrounding cast, the shockwave has obviated the rest of that in the cast. The water of third is completely produced in this one next cast. Water has been detected in interstellar clouds within our galaxy, the Milky Way. Water exists in abundance in other galaxies, too, because its components, hydrogen and oxygen, are among the most abundant elements in the universe. Interstellar clouds eventually condense into the solar nebulae and solar system, such as ours. Water exists in abundance. The existence of liquid water, and to a lesser extent its gaseous and solid forms, on Earth are vital to the existence of life on Earth and beyond it. Earth's surface waters are filled with life. The earliest life forms appear in water. A model view of the Kamina Nebula shows our Earth in a few levels of detail. The fantasy like landscape of the nebula has been sculpted by the action of a floating wind and forcing up the violent radiation from the monster stars that inhabit this inferno. In the process, each star are shredding the surrounding material that is the last vestige of the giant cloud of which the stars were born. The immense nebula is an estimated 7,500 light years away in the southern constellation Kamina Rookie. The bubble in it is located in the light of cyanide hydrogen. Color information from that is this data taken at the 7th of October in Suramerica of the curvature in Chile. Red comet from water sulfur, green to hydrogen, and blue to oxygen emission. Water exists in abundance. In astronomy, the habitable zone takes depth in the distance of a star capable of barely yet to attest with the light similar to our own. The habitable zone is not to be confused with planetary habitability. Life is most likely to form within the circumstellar habitable zone, CH10, within a solar system, and the galactic habitable zone, CH10, of the larger galaxy, CH10 may also be reserved for Saturn, light zone, Custom zone, Green belt, or Goldilocks zone. It doesn't, neither to one nor to go, but does light.
Ocean, known diameter with a 71
attempt to curb this water. Water methods in a bucket in the universe. It appears of liquid water and the measurement kept in gaseous and solid form. Others are vital to the existence of life on Earth and the earth. Earth's surface waters are filled with life. The earth's life form appears in water. Much of the universe's water is produced as a byproduct of star formation. When stars are born, their earth is accompanied by a strong outward unit of sand and dust. When this outflow of material eventually impacts the surrounding star, the shock waves that are created compress that to feed the star. The water on Earth is quickly produced in this warm-dead star. Water has been detected in interstellar clouds within our galaxy, the Milky Way. Water exists in abundance in other galaxies, too, because its components, hydrogen and oxygen, are among the most abundant elements in the universe. Interstellar clouds eventually compress into the solar nebulae and solar systems such as ours. Water exists in abundance. The existence of liquid water, and to a lesser extent its gaseous and solid forms, on Earth are vital to the existence of life on Earth as we know it. Earth's surface waters are filled with life. The earliest life forms appear in water. Bubbles new of the Kamiga Nebula shows our Earth in a new level of decay. The fantasy life landscape of the nebula is sculpted by the action of outflowing winds and forcing ultraviolet radiation of the monster stars that inhabit this inferno. In the process, these stars are shredding the surrounding material with that is the last vestige of the giant cloud on which the stars were born. The immense nebula is an estimated 7,500 light years away in the southern constellation Kamiga the Bean. The bubble images were taken in the light of the ionized hydrogen. Color information was added with greater taste than the semi-tonometer American observatory in Chile. Red corresponds to sulfur, green to hydrogen, and blue to oxygen emission. Water exists in abundance. In astronomy, the habitable zone HZ is the distance of a star capable of bearing extraterrestrial light similar to our own. The habitable zone is not to be confused with planetary habitability. Light is most likely to form within the circumstellar habitable zone, CHZ, within its solar system, and the galactic habitable zone, CHZ, of the larger galaxy. CHZ may also be the Earth's or Saturn's light zone. Comfort zone, weak then formed only on stone, because it's neither too hot nor too cold, but just right.
I'm going to go to the next one. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.